Hey everybody, welcome back to QCR. Today on QCR, we're going to take this carpet off of these stairs here and we're going to replace it with some hardwood. Let me show you the tools we're going to use for this. So, in order to get the carpet off, we're going to have to rip it up and we're going to have to pull the staples out. Trusty little pliers here, we're going to pull the staples out. There's going to be a padding under this carpet. We got our little blade here. We're gonna cut that padding. There's gonna be a tack strip all around here. We're gonna see if this works. Pull that tack strip up. I bought two of them. I don't know which one's gonna work best. Do it like that right there. And then we're gonna put some pine on here. I was gonna put oak, but oak is $30 a tread. Pine is $10 a tread. So pine it is, pine it shall be. So we're gonna do these stairs here. Rip them all up. Let's see here. Rip these up. We got this Ryobi brad nailer. 2-inch nails. And we're going to put some glue on it. Then we're going to stain it. Hopefully it comes out this color when we stain it. This is the pine here. I was practicing my nailing. Make sure my nailer works. I'm going to cut that end off. These are 40 inches, I need 38 inches, or maybe that's 44 inches, I don't know. So I'm gonna cut that down, rip all the carpet off, cut my pine down, put it on, and then I'm gonna show y'all how I use the Ryobi. And I got some glue, first we're gonna glue it, then put some nails in it, and I'm gonna show y'all step by step. All right, I'm gonna take a few pieces of carpet up and I'll show y'all what's under it. Alright, so I pulled this corner up right here. I'm gonna pull the rest away. Let y'all see what we're doing. Let me get my pliers on there. I should use my hand, so. Comes up just like that. What was that? Oh, texture. So, you can hear my heavy breathing. I don't mind. I'm just gonna do it. Are they gonna come up one piece at a time? One piece at a time. Bye bye, piece. Bye bye. So, this is under it. Heavy stair breathing. So, we got our. Ooh, it comes up easily. Usually, it don't come up that easily.
According to YouTube.
Pull this little piece up. Perfect. So. We got these little nails here, or those are staples. What's that? There's a staple in there. So that's what you gotta do. Go through. There's junk right there. Here's a staple. I like these. Look, they're spring-loaded. So you don't have to use your pinky to push them back out. These are really nice. So I go down this whole set of stairs. All these little staples out. So, that's what I'm going to do. Alright, let's pull that up. Let's see how easy that is. Alright. That's not hard. So look at that. Just comes right up. Ooh. Look how pokey that is. That looks sharp, doesn't it? You gotta be careful not to step on that. Alright, let's see if this yellow one works. Yep, yellow one works. Alright, so I'm gonna do all these stairs. Turn this around. Alright, so I'm gonna do all these stairs. Get all this off on the stairs. Then I'm gonna come back, I'm gonna show you my measurements and I'm gonna measure it. Probably 38 inches. Then I'll show you how I glue it on there and then nail it back down in there. And then you're gonna appreciate it. And then you're gonna give me a thumbs up before you finish the video. Alright, right back. All right, guys, I got the carpet off. All right, let's look at what it looks like. So, those are the pads. Got it off right there on that top step. So we gotta take all these pads off. I'm pretty excited it wasn't all a bunch of pieces. It came down in one piece, well, two pieces. Top one was one piece. Rest was another piece. So here it is on the floor. Right there, you can see it. It's all right here. So we're gonna get that. I need to get me a trash can so I can plop these little staples in so they don't go everywhere. All right, I'm gonna start ripping these tack boards off and this padding off. As you can see, the padding, there it is there. I got like super fat man stair breathing going on right now. So I'm gonna rip the padding off, get the tacks out of there. Then I'm gonna show you what it looks like after I get all that off, okay? All right, guys, I got everything off here. Got all the tacks and nails and stuff out. I think probably a few more hidden in here I'm gonna find. So next step is to get all this paint and nonsense off that's on here. I thought I was gonna use this guy here. It's actually a polisher, but it has the Velcro plate on there. So I figured, oh, I guess sandpaper. Put it on there, and it'll work. No, it doesn't work, so I'm gonna have to go to back to the store, get a little cheap little sander, get all this junk off. I need to rough this up so I can put the glue to it, because I'm glue's not gonna stick to paint and whatever nonsense is on there. So I have to go back to the store, get a little sander, come back, finish this up. There's some tack strips there. Made a big mess down here. Big old mess down here. Got all these tack strips down there. So I'm gonna do that. Go to the store, grab a sander, come back, sand this all up real good, and then I'll start cutting the wood and gluing it down. Show you my awesome progress. Make sure you give me one of these. All right, everybody, this is where we're at. I had to go to the store, buy this little sander here. Realized it's not gonna get the edge. See, it's missing that. It's not getting this edge piece here. And so I went to the store and got another little sander. This is like 15 or 20 bucks at Walmart. Not that bad. It gets the edge. It gets all the way over there, as you can see. Both sides pretty good. So we're gonna get all this paint off here. That paint, I'm pretty sure it's paint. Get all that off there, take it down to raw wood, and then we're going to do some cuts, get our next piece put on here, our actual treads is what they're called. So we'll get all this removed, and then we'll get our treads put on, and I'll show you all that part. All right, guys, so got most of all the junk off the top there. Anything you see here is in the little grooves or divots or whatever, so it's not gonna come off. All right, so I made my first cut. This is 38 inches. That's what it looks like. So it looks like it's not square, but this part is just pushed back a little too far, the riser area. So that's what it's gonna look like. So we're gonna pull this back up. Pull it back up, wipe it down real good, get all the dust off, put the glue on there, and then we're gonna put it back down with the glue on there, and then we're gonna nail it. I'm gonna show you how to do it. All right, guys, so I got this liquid nails here. We're gonna put it on this board, put it on the bottom side of the board. Let's go ahead and cut it open. Need a lot. Doesn't want to cut. Dang it. Let's pause that. Get some more light in here. Alright, so we've got our liquid nails open. So we're going to apply a liberal amount. I don't like saying the word liberal. the bottom side of the step here. Let's get it all out there. I probably went up too high right here because it's going to hang over. Good amount here. Good amount on the back. Some here. I'm going to use a lot. You're going to be walking up and down the stairs forever and ever. And ever. Alright. So, to show the camera how much I got on there. Look at that. Pretty good amount, huh? So we're going to flip it over. Slap that bad boy in there. I want to sit here and look down my edge, make sure it's straight with my tile. Make sure it's straight with my tile. It's up against the edge here pretty good. Press down on it real good. Now we got our nail gun. Ryobi, 2-inch, 18 gauge. We're just going to come across pretty close to the edge so that our trim can cover it up. Do a few on each side. Look at it. Yep, it's in there. A few on the back, kind of close to the edge, trim will cover it up. Alright, so we've got a riser. Got some, get some glue on here. Pretty good amount. Alright, now we're just gonna set it in there. Get in there real nice, push real good. Make sure the glue sticks. Get our nail gun. Pop a couple. Did this not work again? This thing's junk. What's wrong with it? Something's wrong with this free nailer. Yeah. Alright, so if you had a good nail gun, instead of a borrowed nail gun, probably wouldn't jam like that all the time. So put the tread, put the riser, do it all the way up. I'll start recording when I can make some more progress. Show you how. It's actually pretty easy. It's just I'm doing this learning curve. It's my first time. It's really not hard. I'm just taking my time. Making sure everything's correct. Alright guys, so we got all these stair treads in here. So I gotta put the riser in there. I get all the way to the top. Whoopsie. So I get to this one. And let me tell you what I had to do. I had to take an inch off the back here because we got our carpet here and doesn't go as far back. And I decided not to cut the carpet here because I watched a lot of YouTube videos on it. And some people are just cutting it here and cutting it here and cutting it here. And some of them kind of loop over. I said, you know what? It's already there. Just keep it there. So that'll be that. And also, look at all these nail holes. Those nail holes. And this whole time, I was like, why is my board moving? Why is my board moving? So why is my board moving? Oh, there's no holes. My nail gun wasn't working. Daggum Ryobi. Just puncturing it and not working. There was a nail jammed in there. I didn't even know it. So I'm getting frustrated, but now we're gonna put the last nails in. See if it works. Is there a nail in there? Let's see if it. Oh, it feels tight. Good. All right, let's put about 1,700 more nails in there. All right, everything's better now. So, got the last tread in. I'm gonna stain it. And that stain is gonna make those holes look a little bit different. You won't be able to see them as much. So that's that. I get my nailer. So we're gonna go. We're gonna get our risers. See, it looks good coming down it. Looks pretty decent. Down like that. Don't trip on that little piece of metal there. So that looks good. I'm gonna stain it. Hopefully, it kinda, I want my stain to get dark like that. I don't know what color that is, but I get like that. It's gonna look good here when we get finished. Alright. Zoom it out. Alright guys, I'm gonna show you how I did the risers here. So this one, the first one, looks like it says 6.5. Gotta get in there real good. It's actually slightly less than 6.5. So got this, got it cut, fits in there nice and snug. We're gonna put some glue on here. Put it in. Set it there for a second. Get some glue. Look at that. Plenty of glue. Plenty of glue. Probably don't need that much. Not gonna walk on it. Let me set my camera up. Glue. Glue on there. Pull this bad boy out. See, just like that. And flip it in there. Push it in there real good. We're just gonna take a couple of nails. Slide some nails in there. So, we're gonna go make our second cut. We're gonna make our second cut. Or actually, our third cut. All right, everyone. So we're almost done with the stairs. As you can see them in the background here. Got all the carpet off. Got the treads down. Risers down. I just need to get some trim. Let me show you why. So, look here at the stairs. Look at that. That big ugly gap right there. So my house was built in 1981, so the flooring beneath it isn't quite square for when you do it like this. They put carpet on there, so they know it didn't have to be perfect, but look at that gap. That's ugly, so I gotta get some trim. I'm gonna trim it all up real nice, all the way down the sides. See, this one fits pretty good right there. This one has a little gap. This one's a little gap. I mean, for the most part, if you just walked in, you wouldn't know it, but looking at it, I see it. It's ugly. There's a huge gap right there. Little gap right there. That's ugly. But let's see what it looks like walking down it. When you walk down the stairs. And I messed my paint up right there. I didn't want to repaint, but I guess I have to now. Don't touch those with your hands. Put some gloves on. They're tight. I mean, they're not tight. They're sharp. I say tight. So looking down, we see some gaps. Little gap right there. Ugly. Little gap over here. I don't know what happened to that piece of wood. That's ugly. That gap right there is ugly. Gap on the other side. So looking down, I mean, other than the gap on the edge that needs some trim, it looks pretty sharp. Everything's on there real good. So just the trim, I get the trim finished up, I'll make another video of trimming it out and put some stain on it. My back hurts. So, happened to the camera. So, I mean, that's actual work wasn't hard, it's just time consuming, and it kind of sucks doing it. But you can definitely do it yourself if you got the right tools. Let's look at some tools I used, and let's not. It's really not hard, it just sucks. Probably pay someone, unless you have the tools, then don't pay someone. Alright, if you like my video, give me a thumbs up. Really wasn't too hard, just sucks. And make sure you share with everyone that's not. Next time it'll be a lot easier than this time. This time it was just a learning curve, really. I spent more money than what I needed to. Alright guys, peace out. Give me a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. Or is it over here? Probably over here. Might be over there. I don't know. Alright, later.